Now students, after discussing the introduction of the time, let us take some questions from your book exercise. And the first question says, write the time in figures. So the time is given in words and you have to write it in figures. So the first part, 23 minutes past 5. So what will be the time? The time will be 23 minutes is already passed and passed after 5. So your time will be 523. 523. Or you can write 0523. So this is your time, 23 minutes past 5. The second one, half past 8. Half past. Half past means 30 minutes past. So your time will be 08 in hours and 30 minutes. So your time is 8:30. Clear, students? Coming to the second question, in which you have to write the time using AM or PM. As I have already told you, if it is 12 midnight to 12 noon, the time is AM. And if it is 12 noon to 12 midnight, then it is PM. So 5:30 in evening. This is the time between 12 noon to 12 midnight. So what it will be? It will be 5:30 p.m. 5:30 p.m. The second one, 15 minutes past midnight. It is past midnight. That means after midnight. So that will be 15 minutes past. So what you will write? You will write it as 00:15 because it is 15 minute past and it is midnight to mid noon, that means 12 midnight to 12 noon, so it is 00:15 a.m. This will be the time of a.m. Clear, students? You can write it as 00:15 a.m. or you can also write it as 12:15 a.m. Both the ways it is correct. Okay, students? After this, the third question, in which you have to change the 12-hour clock to 24-hour clock. So how to write the time which is given in 12-hour clock to 24-hour clock. So the time, if it is AM, then you directly have to write the value in hours. If it is PM, then you have to add 1200 hours to the given time. So here in the first part, it is 10:10 a.m. Just because it is a.m., so you will be writing the value in the same manner, 10:10, and you have to remove the two signs, the two dots here. Okay, so it will become 10:10 hours, and now your time is in 24-hour clock. Just because it was a.m., directly you have to write the value, and it becomes 10:10 hours. Coming to the second part, in which it is p.m., right? It is p.m. So very first, you will be writing this number, or you can say you will be writing this time in 4-digit value. Since you can see the count here 1, 2, 3, there are only 3 digits. So very first, you will write 0, 1, 4, 5. This is your time which is in 12-hour clock. And just because it is p.m., so to convert this into 24-hour clock, we will add 1200 to this. So what will be the sum of these two values? It will become 1345. That means 1345 hours. This is the conversion from 12-hour clock to 24-hour clock. Understood? Next question. Change into 12-hour clock. Now 24-hour clock is given to you and you have to convert this into 12-hour clock. So for that, as we have added 1200 here, now in this we have to subtract 1200. But in which case? The cases in which your hour hand is more than 12. If your hour hand is giving a value more than 12, then you have to subtract it by 1200 and you have to put PM there. Okay. So in the first part, you can see the time is 1640 hours. And here you can see the hour hand is greater than 12. So what you will do? We will do 1640 minus 1200. So subtracting the value here, you will get put the two dots here. So it becomes 440. And what it is? Just because you have subtracted by 1200, so it will become PM. So it is 440 PM. Okay, students? If we have not subtracted by 1200, then we will write AM. Coming to the second part, in which 600 hours. Here, the hour hand is showing a time less than 12. So this will be directly written as 600 with the two dots. That means it is now in 12 o'clock a.m. So it is 6 a.m. Then the third part, 2110 hours. So that will be 2110 minus 1200. Subtracting the value here, what you will get? 9 10 9 10. And what it is, since we have subtracted by 1200, it will be PM. So the time is 9 10 PM. Understood, students, how to convert a 12 hour clock to 24 hour and 24 hour clock to 12 hour. Now coming to the last question, in which you have to indicate the time when the position of hour hand and minute hand is given to you. In the first part, it is said that your hour hand is between 2 and 3. Your hour hand is between 2 and 3 and minute hand at 4. So if we draw a clock, if I roughly draw the clock, so this is our clock. Okay. Now, if we check out the position, hour hand is between 2 and 3. So the hour hand is between 2 and 3 and the minute hand is at 4. The minute hand is at 4. So students, can you see what is the time here? Yes, the time is 2:20. 2:20. Or you can also write it as 20 minutes past 2. 20 minutes past 2. Okay? Like we write it as 15 minutes past. Similarly, you can write 20 minutes past 2, or you can write it as 2:20. Both the ways it is correct. Coming to the second part, in which our hand, what is our hand? It is between 11 and 12. So if I make the diagram in the same clock, what is our hour hand? Hour hand is between 11 and 12. So this is our hour hand. And minute hand between 9 and 10 at the first division. It is between 9 and 10. And where between 9 and 10? Because 9 and 10 is subdivided into 5 divisions. So it is said that at the first division. So if I talk about the 5 divisions like this, so our minute hand is at this place, at the first division. So what is the value of minute hand at when the needle is at 9? 9 into 5, which is 45. Now if I talk about the next subdivision, so it will become 46, because one division means 1 minute extra. So what is your time? Our hand is between 11 and 12, so it is 11, we will count as 11, and the minute hand is at 6, 46, so it is 11:46. Clear, students? So this is your time, 11:46, because your minute hand is between 9 and 10 at the first division. If it was at second division, then we have written as 47. If it is at third division, then it will become 48. 11:48, 11:49, 11:50, like this. Okay, students? So with this, we have ended this topic today. I hope you have understood the concept. Kindly go through your book exercise and complete the questions in your notebook. Thank you for the lesson, students. Have a great day.